This is Corey Ellison, dramaturg at New York City Opera. Agrippina is one of the jewels in our crown of Handel opera productions here at City Opera. We have 11 in all, and it's based on ancient Roman history, but I promise you this is no textbook. What it is, actually, is a bedroom farce. It's the story of Nero, but not the scruffy old Peter Ustinov Nero who fiddled while Rome was burning. This Nero is a cute but hormonal teenage slacker, and you can already smell the depravity to come. And his mother is Agrippina, a sort of shamelessly ambitious and unscrupulous Joan Collins type, scheming to get Nero on the emperor's throne. This bunch would make the Carringtons of Dynasty blush. Nobody here dies of natural causes. All the characters are rats, and we love them. Agrippina is an opera of youth. Handel wrote it when he was just 24 years old and wrapping up an apprenticeship in Venice. It was a huge success. In fact, it put him on the map. It launched his career as an operatic composer. The role of Agrippina is one of the great diva roles of all time, like a Cleopatra or a Carmen. She's got this spectacular mad scene in Act Two, just chock full of florid and dramatic singing. Cast includes City Opera favorite mezzo-soprano Jennifer Rivera as Nero, and the countertenor David Walker, who gets to play Ottone, the one and only nice guy in the whole opera. The production is by director Lillian Groag and designer John Conklin, and it perfectly captures all of the wit and madness in the music and in the plot. The design of Agrippina manages to be both classical and timeless at the same time. They use classic shapes and theatrical elements, given a kind of a very modern sort of Armani twist. Agrippina is brilliant music wedded to brilliant comedy. When you see it, you'll never think of Roman history the same way again.